You may have heard that alpaca woolen products are stain resistant, but what do you actually do when you spill something on an alpaca woolen garment? How do you remove the stains? Let me show you. When you accidentally spilled something on an alpaca woolen garment, there is one rule. The quicker you are, the better your chances are that you will actually be able to get rid of the stain. Now, on the other hand, there's different types of stains, so it depends a little bit on what you spilled on your garment and how you're going to want to get rid of it. So when you spill something sticky like ketchup, for example, the best thing to do is to just shake it off as quickly as possible. Because of the fiber texture, there's not really a lot of opportunity for the ketchup to leave a stain. So wick it off as quickly as you can, and that should solve the problem. Do be careful where you throw it at, though, because you might save your woolen garment, but if you, I don't know, slam it on the wall, you have maybe an even bigger problem, so be careful. If the stain does remain or if there is any part that you can shake off, then try to rinse it off with just some cold running water. When you spill something more liquid, like wine, for example, you're going to want to be a little quicker because obviously the wine will get absorbed by the fiber. And even though the red wine stain on this little patch of wool here didn't leave a stain, if I would have left it on longer, it would have. So be careful with that. So what you can do again is like wipe off the drops as quickly as possible. And if you have a tissue or a napkin to pat off whatever liquid is getting absorbed by the fiber, and that should help a great deal. If the stain is still there, then again, you want to rinse it off with cold water. Now, if you spill something that is leaving an even bigger stain, like coffee, then you're going to need to do a little more than just patting it off and wiping it away. I actually needed to clean this little patch of wool because the coffee wouldn't come off. So I spilled coffee. I couldn't even wipe it off because it was absorbed immediately. And then patting it didn't help because it was such a persistent stain. So I ended up rinsing it under cold water. That helped a lot. But as you can see here, there is still coffee visible. So that's not good. We don't want that. We're going to get rid of the stain, remember? So what did I do? I put the garment, okay, in this case, it's a tiny little piece of wool. I put it in a tub, in a tiny tub, and then I added water to it, again, cold water. And I added a tablespoon of vinegar in there. The vinegar is soft enough that it won't harm the fabric, but it is acid enough that it actually will eat away the coffee and make the stain disappear. So, as you can see here, throwing out the vinegar, rinsing it again with water, cold water, and as you will see, drum roll, it is clean. So I just want to reiterate, alpaca wool is stain resistant, but it is not 100% stain proof. If you leave something long enough on the garment, it will make a stain. And the downside of alpaca wool is that you can't get a brush and rub it off and, you know, use that elbow grease to make the stains disappear, because it will ruin your garment and it will make it felt and it will make it look ugly. You're not going to want that. So preventing is always better, so do not spill anything on your alpaca woolen garment, but in case you do, wipe it off as quickly as possible, rinse it under cold water, worst case scenario, put it in water, cold water with some vinegar. If you really need to wash your alpaca woolen product, I recommend you watching this video, in which I give you a step-by-step explanation on how to wash your alpaca woolen garments properly. Thanks for watching. Oh, don't forget, while we're at it, little thing down below there. I see it somewhere. So wait, where is it? It's a like button. Hit it. Yay. You can hit that like button if you like this video. Thank you for watching this video. I hope to see you in the next one. Better.